recommend that you turn your mobile phones off or on silent. We want to catch every second of our performance, so don't get distracted or distract others with your texts.
Our first pieces of dance from the West End show, Beauty and the Beast.
It's a love story like Romeo and Juliet, but in this story it's not Star Class 7 but the beautiful young woman falling in love with the Beast. The piece we perform is in the first act of West End show and centres around an enchanted crockery set welcoming the beautiful lady for dinner. Without further ado, we have Be Our Guest.
Oh, and one more thing, we hope you enjoy the show.
Ma chère mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. And now, we invite you to relax, let us pull up a chair, as the dining room proudly presents your dinner. Be our guest. Be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie your napkin round your neck, sherry, and we provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot or good. Why, we only live to serve. Try the gray stuff, it's delicious. Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. But to all this is France. And a dinner here makes another second best. Go on and hold your menu, take a glance, and then you'll be our guest. We our guest, be our guest.
Be friends, cheese souffle, I am full of
flambé. We'll prepare and serve with flavor, culinary cabaret. You're alone and you're scared, but the banquet's all prepared. No one's gloomy or complaining, while the flatware's entertaining. We tell jokes, I do tricks, with my fellow candlestick.
Put it all in perfect taste that you can bear.
Come on and lift your glass, to one you're unprepared. Be our guest.
If you're stressed, it's fine dining we suggest.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
Which ran for nearly 6 years.
Whilst my friends take position. Let me introduce Mr. Harlan Upline.
Perfect. Yeah. tell with an extraordinary gift
and a love of reading, although that's not her extraordinary gift.
We have selected experts from the Nobel Prize.
And so we bring you Matilda.
Notice anything unusual about their daughter.
To tell the truth, I doubt they would have noticed had she crawled in the house with a broken leg.
But
Matilda's brother Michael is a perfectly normal boy.
And if that's a problem for anyone, we're more than welcome to help you.
No, I told her don't.
Matilda sat down at her desk. A most extraordinary and peculiar feeling. The feeling was mostly in her eyes. A kind of electricity seemed to be gathering inside them. A sense of power was brewing in those eyes of hers. A feeling of great strength settling itself deep in her eyes. But there was also another feeling which was something else altogether and which she could not understand. It was like flashes of lightning. Little waves of lightning seemed to be flashing out of her eyes. Her eyeballs were beginning to get hot, as though vast energy was building up somewhere inside them. It was an amazing sensation. She kept her eyes steady on the glass, and now the power was concentrating itself in one small part of each eye, growing stronger and stronger, as if tiny millions of hands were reaching forward and shooting out of her eyes towards the glass she was staring at. Miss Trunchbull, the headmistress, was something else altogether. She was gigantic. A fierce, tyrannical monster who frightened the life out of pupils and teachers alike. There was an aura of menace about her, even at a distance. And when she came close to you, you could almost feel the heat radiating from her. When she marched, Miss Trunchbull never walked. She always marched, like a stormtrooper with long strides and arms swinging. But when she marched along a corridor, you could actually hear her snorting as she went. If a group of children happened to be in her path, she ploughed right on through them like a tank. Thank goodness we don't meet people like her very often, although they do exist, and all of us are likely to come across at least one. If you ever do, you should behave as if you met an angry rhinoceros out in the bush. Climb up the nearest tree and stay there until it has gone away.
Bye.